Hare Krishna. We have snakes inside us, but we are not one of them. We all have dark desires within us. These desires are like snakes. They can bite us, and through us they can bite others. Therefore, it's vital that we protect ourselves carefully. It's vital that we guard ourselves. Now, sometimes, despite our attempts to protect ourselves from our dark desires, say such as anger, or lust, or envy, or whatever, sometimes because of these dark desires, we may hurt ourselves terribly. And we may act in such a way that they may hurt others, that we may hurt others also. And this can dishearten us. And sometimes when we act in hurtful ways, sometimes we may even act in evil ways. And people may label us as evil. And we may also start thinking of ourselves as evil. So at such times, we need to be very careful to understand ourselves clearly. That actually, that there are snake-like desires within us, there are snakes inside us, but we are not one of them. That we are not another snake. There are snakes inside us, and those snakes can bite us and bite others through us. But we are pure. We are souls. We are always parts of the divine. As the Bhagavad-Gita says, Mamaivamsho jiva loke jiva bhutaha sanatanaha. That we are eternally the parts of the divine. And no matter what misdeeds we may have done, that doesn't change. Sanatanaha means no matter how grievous be the wrongs that we may have done, still we remain the parts of the divine. And by understanding this, we can avoid getting discouraged. Now, not getting discouraged is good. One extreme is to get so discouraged that to think that we are irredeemable. The Bhagavad-Gita assures that nobody is irredeemable. No matter how bad, grievously somebody has messed up things. It says that if we understand our true identity and act at the level of that true identity, then we can become free. Apichedasi papebhya sarvebhya papakrittamaha sarvam jnanaplavenaiva vrujinam santarishyasi. Just as somebody who is drowning in an ocean, if they get a good boat, they can cross over that ocean. Similarly, we may be drowning in the evil within us. But if we get the boat of spiritual knowledge, of proper understanding of who we are, that we are parts of the divine, that we are parts of all pure, all powerful Krishna. And then when we connect with Him but through devotion, then we can rise above the snakes within us. We can protect ourselves. The remembrance of Krishna becomes like a antidote, that He protects us from the poison of the snakes within us. And in fact, this remembrance of Krishna can actually poison the snakes within us. Krishna says this elsewhere in the Gita, that apichet sudharacharo bhajate mamananyabhak sadhureva samantavya samyagvyavasito hisaha. He says that even if somebody has done grievous wrongs, if they stay devoted to me, then they are well situated. And if they stay devoted to me, kshipram bhavati dharmatma shashvat shantim nigachati kaunteya pratijanihi name bhaktah pranashyati. That if we stay devoted, then we can become pure and free from these impurities. Of course, if we keep giving those snakes free access, free control over us, then we can also become snake-like. There are demoniac people who don't try to fight the snakes within them. Rather, they completely hand over the control of themselves to become to those snakes within, and thus they become snake-like. And they need to be punished. But even they may become snake-like, but they are not snakes. But for purifying them, sometimes they may have to be strongly punished. And maybe it's in a fresh body that they will become purified. But if we are not becoming a willing servant of those snakes, if you are trying to resist those snakes, and if you take shelter of the divine who can protect us within and without, then we all can become purified. So by remembering that we are the parts of divinity and that we can access the supreme divinity, we can protect ourselves from the snakes within, and we can purge ourselves of those snakes within, and thus manifest the divinity within. Thank you. Hare Krishna.